Hello, my name is Sara Monberg. I'm a junior from Jylland in Denmark, and you're on the tee with the Lingual Golf Team. I'm gonna talk to you about my go-to chipping shot. If I have a difficult chip shot where I need to get it up and down to make my par or save my bogey, I pick my putter. There is a big difference in how you think about how you putt and chip in a golf round. For example, in a putt like this, you have a pretty fair straight putt that's a little uphill you could go to make that putt. In long putts, you want to get the ball as close as possible in your first putt, so you can two-putt that putt. When I warm up on a green, I hit a few putts looking at the hole to get the feel for the speed of the greens. That way, it'll make it easier for me to have the feel to get the ball to the hole. I hit about 4 to 5 putts looking at a hole to get the feel for the green. It's not only your body that can feel it, but also your eyes will see the speed of the greens. Now let me show you a few things I have in my golf bag.
Everything in my bag is currently tailor-made. Right now I carry 3 wedges. I have a 52 degree, a 56 degree, and a 60 degree.
This is my markers. I mark my ball normally with an orange sun. I pick my color after what mood I'm in that day, but always at tournaments it's the orange color I use. This is my putter. I have a Odyssey putter number 7.
To wrap things up, I like to use my putter to chip. That's my safe shot to go to make sure I get the ball up and down in the fewest amount of shots as possible. But also remember, in the long putts, it's important to get the ball to the hole. You're not trying to make those putts, because it's important not to free putt. This is with Sara Monberg on a tee. Good luck practicing and get those putts in.